It's not the things inside my head that keep me going. Don't need someone to throw me money, they should show it. Keep chasing shadows, they're always haunting me.
So this has been our breakfast for the last 4 days straight.
Fam. All right, so it is a new day today. We are doing some new training. We started it off on Monday. It's now Wednesday, 8:30 in the morning. We're doing strength training. I've never done strength training in my life. I've only really done bodybuilding, hypertrophy stuff. We're going to be doing a little bit of 5x5 work. So we did it on Monday. We did legs, and I've had to swap my leg day around so that we can actually fit in some deadlifts into our routine. So we did Monday leg day. Yesterday was shoulders. Today's back, so we'll be doing the deadlifts, and then Thursday hammies, and then Friday will be arms. So today we're going to be doing deadlifts, 5 sets of 5, and then weighted chins, 5 sets of 5, and then we'll just move into doing our regular bodybuilding stuff after that. Now, the reason that we wanted to do this strength training block is because I've basically been cutting up and down with the calories all year round, and I decided, you know what, I'm going to do a proper bulk now. I'm going to increase the calories, so we might as well put those calories to use. Maybe 4 to 6 weeks of just strength training, and then just see what we can use with our strength. So I like setting little micro goals as well, just to basically move towards something new. You know, keep the training interesting, and then just see how I can better my body. So that's what we're doing today. Having a glycoject right now. Had a huge bottle of water already. I'm really thinking about my training sessions and fueling up for these lifts. Instead of just waking up in the morning, rolling up to the gym, smashing a pre-workout, and then thinking I'm gonna like PB on lifts, that ain't gonna happen. So had an oat shake this morning as well. Make sure I hydrated, make sure I get this glycoject in me with the creatine. Like, I'm making sure I cover all the little 1%ers. That's my point. Anyway, about to get into it, so let's get a move on. All right, so we've started jotting down our reps that we've been hitting on the board. So for our squat, I started the first week at 155 kilos for 5 sets of 5. Oz was punching out 130, CB was punching out 65. Now, the aim of the game basically is next week, if you do hit all 5 reps on all 5 sets, you go up by about 5 kilos. So I'll punch it up to 160, and then so on. Every week, maybe increase it by 5 kilos or so, if we actually hit all the reps. If we don't hit all the numbers, then we're not gonna increase it. You stay on that. Legs are pretty cooked, not gonna lie. Glutes are killing me. We did a lot of volume on legs the other day. So, I don't know, I set my starting weight at probably 140. So 3 plates aside, and then hopefully next week we'll go up a little bit. Back day, I feel like it's going to be a little bit more of a struggle than legs, because we've got sore legs, and the DOMS is going to play a big factor of our lifts. So I think we'll be pretty good for chest, but we'll be doing that towards the end of the week, so I hope that goes up every week. But I've got a feeling back's going to be a bit of a struggle. So we're doing a really intense warm-up, stretch, and then we'll get into it.
When you're coming up from here, you just want to snap the hips through there, yeah?
Okay, yeah.
Keeping the shoulders tucked really tight.
Yep.
And then as the bar comes past the knees, stand up and smash the hips into the bar.
All right, so we're gonna film pretty much every set that we do so that we can show you guys our mistakes and how we better our form and how to better the movement in order to lift the weight. So my brother's a strength coach, so he's done a lot of deadlifting and power work before, so I'm gonna get him to make sure that he oversees all of our lifts, because like I said, I haven't really done a proper strength training block before. He's gonna coach us through it, and we're gonna show you guys all our little errors so that you can help better your lifts as well. So I'm not trying to claim that I'm like a really strong powerlifter, because I'm not. I do bodybuilding, I'm trying something new, and I wanna learn, and I wanna improve. So we'll show you guys what we're doing.
Pull it in nice and close.
Oh, so you got to put it down after each rep, but yeah, and then reset.
Yeah, you're not gonna let go of the grip though.
No. I meant like, cause we're not gonna join the reps together.
No, don't bounce.
Nah, yeah.
You don't want to be bouncing. You want to, cause everything has to be really nice and tight at the bottom.
Yeah.
Because if it's not tight, once you start getting fatigued, this will start happening. You'll start jolting it.
Oh yeah, yeah.
You know what I mean? So
reset after each rep.
Reset, lock it in nice and tight.
And bang.
Explode out of the hole.
5 individual reps. All right, done. Big OG, you up or am I up?
You're up, brother.
I'll go 140 for the first one then.
Pull the bar in nice and close. Tight back. Sit into it a bit more. Drive with the legs and then snap the hips through.
That was better.
Not bad. I think I gotta get used to like driving harder from the bottom, like the hips.
Yeah,
I was kind of like pulling it up first and then.
Yeah, you're using your lower back to pull it up.
Yeah, felt alright, but first working. I'll get a feel for it.
Yeah.
I was meaning to do 140.
Yeah, bro.
Alright,
sweet. Here you go, G, let's go. Good, bro.
Straight back. Wait. Yep.
Chest
out to the bar, that's better.
That's your position of your back, yeah? Okay, yeah. Just a cheeky. Alright, drop the hips down nice and low.
That's better.
Let's go, power back. Hard.
Push and pull. Push with the legs, pull with the bar. That's better.
Yeah, that's fine, bro.
Yeah?
Oh, yeah.
Feel that?
That'll wake you up.
Yeah. We're setting up really good.
Yeah.
Shoulders were over the bar, but then hips came up. And then you pulled.
Yeah.
Yeah? And what that does is you've got no leg drive from here, so your lower back's taking the load.
Yeah.
And you're having to lever through your lower back. Whereas from here, you want to have your hips nice and tight and then just drive the floor away with your feet. Once the bar comes past your knees, then drive and pull.
Mm.
So it's a push and then a pull. Pulling the bar into you, pushing the floor away.
Let's get it, CB.
Closer. Pull it up against your shins.
That's five.
Yeah, you know why? Because it's out here. Every inch that you lift it out here, that just adds weight to the bar. That's why you want to pull it as close as you can so it comes up in a straight line. If you think about it, like, it's easy for me to pick up this 10 kilo plate in a straight line like this. I put it out here and try to lift it, it gets a lot harder. Yeah, so that's why you want to pull that bar as close as you can to your body.
The bar has to be over the top of the middle of your feet. There. Yeah, better. Bring the hips up a little bit. There, start from there. Good. Big breath. Pull the bar in nice and close. Keep it close. That's better.
That felt heaps better.
That last rep, yeah?
Yeah,
the second last rep, it came out quite in front.
Oh, yeah.
That would have felt a lot heavier, yeah?
Yeah, I think so.
That last rep, you pulled it in nice and close.
It was just finding that balance where to put the hips.
Yeah.
I think for me, like, there's pretty good.
Yeah.
And then just, like, drop into the leg.
Yeah, that's what. That's all you want to do.
Up and back.
No, you don't want to pull up and back.
It's like keeping the chest and forward a bit more.
Yep, that's exactly right. It's almost like that forward jump sort of thing I was explaining before.
Yeah, so what you want to do is you want to tighten your shoulders up, you set your position, and then you use the weight of the bar to tighten everything. So pull the shoulders back nice and tight. And then the tension's in the hammies and glutes, and then you stand.
Yeah, that's better.
Good. Yeah, nice.
Good, clear.
Pull. Tight. That's it. Don't extend through the back. Pull tight through here, and snap the hips through. There.
That was your best set yet. That was good. Much tighter. Fourth set coming up. Here we go.
I'm sweating bullets, bro.
Bar over the middle of your foot. Nice. That's it. Snap the hips through. Fuck the bar. There you go. Better. Much better. Monday through Sunday, yo. There you go. Yeah.
Much more comfortable.
Yeah. Those last two reps were much cleaner.
I feel like I'm using a little bit less back now and just engaging like the glutes and that more.
Yeah.
And then snapping the legs and staying in front of the bar. Where before I was kind of using my lower back to lever up and back.
Like yeah.
That. Shoulders back there. Push the floor away and then snap the hips through. That's it. And again, snap the hips through. Beautiful. Tight. Yeah, that's it. Yeah, tight. And again, move. Good. One. Up. Push. There you go.
That's better, Oz.
Feel better?
Yeah.
Just to feel.
Yeah.
Touch that. Just to feel that.
Yeah. Done.
Done.
So you're getting better with every set, Claire. It's much tighter.
Pull the lats, nice and tight, push the floor away. That's it, power. Power through the hole. Push and pull. Push and pull, pull. There you go, that's better. Always your last rep's the best.
The last one's always
good. So it takes him a few shots to get it.
A few grind sets, and then the last one, I just like it, that small snap.
Once you get the reps under your belt, bro,
you know? Get more confident with it.
It's like boxing, man. Once you get the rounds under your belt, you're better.
All right. You're up, Oz, man. Last set, best set. All right, guys, so that's our five sets done. First week of deadlifts off the floor. Like I said earlier, I'm used to doing it off a rack, so I haven't really pulled anything off the floor in a very long time. So I do have a lot to work on, but that's good. I filmed it. I just watched some of the footage back. What I've realized from my own technique and what I can improve on is that my hips, once I set it, they're just raising up a little bit, meaning that a little bit weak through my core, which means I got to try and strengthen that up because that's the opposing side to what we're working. And I need to try and stay a little bit more sturdy through the initial phase of the movement. So that's good though. You know, I like watching myself back. So it's a trick that you guys can use if you're trying to better your technique on a particular exercise, is just to film it and then look at it from an external perspective. Because when you're looking in the mirror, sometimes it's really hard to actually see what's going on. So yeah, first week down, not too bad. We'll work on it. All right, now we're gonna do the weighted chins. This is another kind of new movement because we're used to using the lat pull down. So I don't know how we'll go on this, but it should be fun. I can feel a little bit of imbalance. Just one sitting a little bit tighter than the other.
Let's go, CB. Get it. Good. Did that feel better, that set? Yeah. So with CB, we were just saying that it's probably a little bit easier to engage the lats if you keep your hips and your legs backwards. Don't bring them up forward like that, because then you'll pull through your arms more. So arch your back and pull straight up, like pull your chest up to the bar. Check out this photo my mum just posted on the gram. She's learning my new prestos. Hashtag Nike, hashtag new, hashtag presto, hashtag thanks Alex. We're teaching her well, bro, we're teaching her well.
100%. Their shoe game.
That's it. Mum's got to stay fresh. She's been coming to the gym lately, so she needs workout clothes. What's this? That's not color order, bro. Fix it, Joey. Can't have that. Oh, bro, you will get punished. Joey, it's all G, bro.
All right, guys, so we've just finished up doing our two power movements, which is the deadlifts and the weighted chins. We did 5x5 on each of those. Then on the last set of the weighted chins, we just did a drop set, pumped out about 10 reps after that. Now we're moving into our bodybuilding side of things. So we're doing the deadlift shrug superset with the barbell row. This is like my element. I feel like I'm in my zone again. Hit the strength at the start of the workout, then throw in the volume just to get a little bit of blood through the muscles and get that little bit of more size and detail. Energy levels are still there though. We've still got a lot to go. hooked it. That felt pretty good, actually. Still got quite a bit of energy left in the traps and all that because we haven't really targeted those movements yet. So we're going to do about 3 sets of this and then move into doing some low lats through the seated row machine that we used last time. Big OG. Last set, best set. Four. Let's go. Come on. 5. Get it, bro. 6. 7. Release slowly. 8. Good. Control the whole way. 9. And 10. Good. All right. Stand up tall. Moving into the deadly shrug now. Let's go. Shrugging it from the bottom. Pulling the shoulders up to your ears and backwards. Squeezing the middle of the traps. Let's go, bro. Right here. Squeeze these 2 points on your shoulder blades together at the top. Hold it. Hold it. And then release. Good. As much time under tension as you can. Good. Slowly go down. Pull up and hold. Hold. Release. Good. Rip it out, bro. Big back. Shredded mess. And last one. Perfect. It was good that you lift your chin up with the movement, bro. It gives you extra tension on the back of the neck, which gives you more mind to muscle connection. My man.
Yeah,
is it on?
It's all right, on.
Good. So what we're doing now is a 10-10 combo. So we're going under grip first, leaning forward, rolling it into our stomach, squeezing the Christmas tree in the lower lats. Then we're putting it down, flipping our hands over the top, thumbs over grip, and then we're gonna be rolling it to above the belly button. So we're trying to hit from shoulder to shoulder, middle traps, rhomboids, and a little bit of upper trap as well. So we'll do 10 reps, 10 reps, and then 5 pump reps to finish it off, just to get that little bit of a burn. All right, done, done. One important tip when you're doing this under grip, keep a little bit of a bend through your elbows and don't fully extend your arms out like that. If you want to keep the pressure on the lower lat, flare the elbows out slightly, keep a bend, reach forward just to where your lats let you go, and then roll it in nice and slowly. Chest out, leaning forward, rowing to the stomach, squeezing and holding. Oh. Oh. Ah. All right, pump reps, here we go. About, bro. 25 reps total. That's fucking burning it, bro. Heart rate through the roof. Alright, so just to finish up our workout, we're going to be doing 2 sets of dumbbell rows, pretty heavy, and then 2 sets of lat pull downs, and then that's it. So a little less volume to today's workout because we've just been using our central nervous system so much, so we're pretty cooked already, but I can't do a back workout without doing any one arm rows. It's just a fundamental movement for developing the lower lats.
Yeah.
What'd you boys order? It's avocado.
Two pizzas, the usual, and a burrito.
Oh, and the burrito.
Yeah. You gotta eat the avocados, that's good fats.
Yes, get it, son. Get it. All the fats. You're missing out on the gains, Joey. That's gains right there, bro. You're just throwing them away. Oh, man. At least someone's getting it. Are we sitting outside or?
Up to inside?
Yeah, man. It's a bit chilly.
Right, so this has been our breakfast for the last 4 days straight. The avocado pillow with poached eggs on top and the breakfast burritos on the way. I feel like we've worked for this meal, bro.
No, I'm gonna eat both breads today, bro. Yeah, I need both bread. Oh, yes. Look at that eggs. Feel fragile at the moment. Yeah. Yeah. No strength to even cut the bread. Struggling here. They nail it every time. So consistent.
Perfect.
Wow.
That's the burrito.
Yes, and that's not so much.
Is it good?
Yeah, good.
Yeah. Oh, you can't pick it up, huh?
Oh, you got the sauce on there.
Oh, yeah, it's gotta be soft.
Yeah.
You gotta get it while it's fresh.
Yeah.
You put the lemon or?
No, I didn't.
Too acidic.
Yeah.
Wow.
Yeah, man.
It's got a good kick to it.
The beans.
Yeah. A little bit spicy. That'll make me sweat bullets.